section, number 25 of the East. Gus really turns them on in hometown Baltimore. Gus Johnson scores.
Gus Johnson of Idaho.
Gus Johnson moved like a man who didn't have two bad knees. Gus Johnson added the coup de grace.
Known around the league as Honeycomb, Gus Johnson was ahead of his time.
His nickname was Honeycomb because he was so sweet.
As everybody called Gus, I just didn't call him Gus, they called him Honeycomb.
There's not many archives of former players, and some of his would have been as spectacular as some of the things we see today. He was a good guy who played and competed at a real high level.
After being drafted in 1963, Gus Johnson would go on to average a double-double over his career with 17 points and nearly 13 rebounds per game. Gus was voted to the 1964 All-Rookie Team, twice named to the All-Defensive First Team, a four-time All-NBA Second Team member, and was also named a five-time All-Star.
Playing in his fourth All-Star game, a great defensive player from Idaho at 6'6", Gus Johnson.
Although Gus was known as a rebounder and a great defensive player, he was also known as a high-flying dunker, which once prompted the late Abe Poland to describe him as the Dr. J of his time.
You're the first guy to tear down a basket in the NBA. That was the type of power that he brought to the game.
Gus Johnson played 9 seasons with the Baltimore Bullets and finished out his career by winning a championship with the Indiana Pacers. Just months after having his number 25 jersey retired by the Bullets in 1987, Johnson died of a brain tumor at age 48.
I often wonder, maybe if we had all played in a different era and maybe he had had a longer career, you know, what people really would have thought of him.
I thought Gus was a great athlete and was a great personality. I'm happy for him.
And I'm very honored that he's finally been inducted to the Basketball Hall of Fame. It's well deserved and long overdue.